guys with a road problem in a country called the Poconos. This is the Pocono Report on Tour Progress. After almost a year, a damaged road in Middle Smithfield Township is getting the finishing touches today. Well, News 13's Vanessa Friedman was on site and joins us now with the latest. Vanessa, what's going on there?
Well, George, there's a lot going on after a month of nothing going on, and it took thousands of dollars in a joint partnership to get the ball rolling.
Township meeting last month, residents were fed up with the incomplete gravel road on Big Ridge Drive, and Roadmaster Bob Spano didn't put residents at ease.
I have to deal with it for the next year because I refuse.
Fast forward a few weeks, the road is finally being completed after 9 months and a slew of residential complaints.
We felt especially bad for some of the residents that lived right near this with the dust that's been flying around. I'm sure it's been very difficult for them to deal with.
Yesterday, construction workers prepped the road here on Big Ridge Drive, and as you can see, early this morning they started laying the concrete, and they say they may be done as early as tomorrow.
It's really being done quite quick compared to if it would have had to been contracted out and, you know, going through the whole process.
But the township's money didn't pay for this project. The CCP Property Owner Association South, who are former owners of this road, dug into their private maintenance fund, giving the township $12,000 to pave the road.
Oh, we're thrilled. I think it's been a great opportunity to show that we can work together with the township, provide safety and a good road system for our residents here at CCP. So we're delighted to see this finally happening.
Residents are rejoicing now that the road project is finally being seen to fruition. But using private funds for a township road has some residents a little unsettled.
I would say a little bit appalled. I mean, it was their decision to take over the road. They indicated that it would be corrected by June.
Scott Shaler says without the contribution, the road would have remained unfinished for at least a year until next year's budget was settled.
We're really strapped. I mean, between taxation, taxes aren't coming in. And, you know, it's the same thing that people are feeling all across the country. We're feeling as a municipality also.
When we left the work site this morning, workers were nearly halfway complete with paving the right side of the road, but they say it'll be good as new by Friday and maybe even Thursday. For News 13, I'm Vanessa Freeman. George, back to you.
All right, thank you, Vanessa.